start my June mission inspiration, even though it's almost July. Behind. So I've got these maps. Which one should I use? I quite like this one. This one's an Ordnance Survey of Wales. And it's got all of the Wales is very, very hilly, shall we say. So it's got a lot of contour lines on it. Makes it a bit more interesting, so I'll cut a bit of that off. Last bit, stick this down. Still not loving this gel medium, I have to say. It's the Dina Wakely one. It's not for me. My map's upside down. Anyway. Yeah, the birds outside. Lovely, isn't it? So then I'm going to use some washi tape, so that's maps, and now we've got washi tape, and I've got these from the washi shop, stuff all over my hands, tissue there, let's use that, here we go, from the bottom, because I want these ones. Matches the colour scheme, the purpley scheme. And the above and beyond theme. Sandwiched in there. Okay. maybe. Okay, now then, let's have a little look at the prompts to see if we can get an idea for what's next. Oh, I'm not quite on here. Oh, it's navy on this one. I thought it was purple. Navy and magenta. Maps, washi. So I need lettering, doodles, and glitter. So. I think I know what I want to do for the glitter. Doodles. I'm really not good at doodles. This hair keeps getting caught up in there. There we go. Let's just spread out some of that. What I think is going to be next is a navy wash or something like so. We will let that dry. And we'll come back with that. Sorry about the noise there. My neighbour's just under the table now. But I'm going to go in now with this Liquitex acrylic ink. And I'm going to drop some on the page. Oh, I forgot I was going to test it first. Never mind. Drop some on the page. And I've got a damp brush and I'm just gonna, yeah, that looks nice, yeah. Just gonna spread it. Getting a little bit of resistance in places on the washi tape and such, but that's okay. See how it dries. Going for that sort of wishy-washy look on this. There we go. So, I'll let that dry and then we'll come in with the navy then. Now, add this sheet of very thick plastic that I have made myself a mask from. And I'm going to pop that right in the middle. Well, a bit more to the top, but in the middle-ish. Now, need my palette paper, which I should have got before, I think. Very organised, me. And I'm going to have to mix up a navy because I do not have a navy paint, but that shouldn't be a problem. I'm going to use this bright blue. Spatula and a dot of this paint's grey. Let's give it a good shake. Right. And we will mix until we get the shade that we want. I also have a lighter blue if I needed. Oh, that's gone really dark. Okay. I think a little darker. Okay. So let's grab, should have a little sponge in here somewhere, maybe not. Yep, I have misplaced it. Okay. Let's grab one from out of here then. So I've moved it over here. Never mind. Hopefully. See, it's not very opaque. I'm not sure how well that mask has actually worked. I think I can see some has gone underneath, but never mind. You get the idea. Quite liking that now. Let's just go edges. Not bad. Okay. Get that dry, then I think gold maybe the next, the gold glittery bits might be the next step, so I'll be back in a flash. Okay, so I've popped my mask back down and I've got this Lindy's Yellow Rose of Texas, and I'm going to grab the nozzle out. Flick. In fact, let's go crazy. I don't have many pale colours, but I've got some Bells of Ireland green. Bachelor Button Glue. Getting it all over the place as ever. And Peony Scarlet Red. And these have fabulous mica in them, so they're gonna glitter and shimmer everywhere. Okay. Let's pop those back. Yeah, so that's dyed back nicely. I was hoping it would because it was a bit garish. So I've popped some white paint on my palette and I'm just going to pop some little bit of water with it. Got my fan brush. Water it down a little. Pop the mask back. Obviously it's not perfect circle because I cut it by hand, but the white splashes too. Don't mind if we get big clusters, that looks quite nice. For this, right. Now I need to dry that off again and then we need to come in. What have we got left? Doodles and lettering, I believe. Let me just check. Yes, we've got the glitter, we've got the maps, we've got the washi, we've got all the colours in there, we've got the gold in there now. Yeah, so I think I'm going to grab... I feel like I need some sort of other focal point besides the big circle. So we'll see. I'm sorry, the light is really bad, isn't it? The sun's coming through. So yeah, have a think about that. Once it's dry, I'll be back. Okay, so I'll pull the blind down a little bit, put the light on so you can see a bit better. So, doodling. Really noisy out there, but it's a nice hot day, so everyone's doing housework and gardening and bits and bobs in the garden and all that, so can't really blame them, can we? And I need my window open because it is really warm in here. So, wibbly wobbly. Should have grabbed my sticker book out also. But that's okay because I think I need to dry that chalk marker off first because it's still just sitting on the surface, so I will do that. Now, do I use him? Or do I use the balloon? And then you need some help staying down. We shall see. But for now, and last thing is lettering. So let's just have a look what we've got in here. Let's see if I like any of these. No. Okay, so we're going to have to, let's see if I can find a probably Oscar one. Yeah, that's a paint one, so let's see. Disturbing those Lindys. So. Never mind. I'm going to write that this is the June. Inspiration, but it is indeed the 15th of July. There we go. It's not fantastic, but it's fun, and I finally finished it. So now I need to figure out what I'm going to do for July's mission, which is sort of the circus theme, I believe. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll catch you again soon.